Good morning, everybody. I am Professor Muhammad Wasim Akram. Welcome to all of you in my video lecture series. I have been teaching this course for the last 12 years. These video lectures will be very useful to the students of civil engineering. So keep watching, like, comment, share, and subscribe our channel. Thank you. Good morning, students. Today we will learn about hydrometer method or hydrometer analysis. This is applicable for fine grain soil. Fine grain soils having more than 50% material passing the 75 micron sieves means fine soils are those which passes through 75 micron. Since the finest sieve size used in the sieve analysis is 75 micron, this analysis is based on Stokes' law, according to which the velocities of free fall of spherical fine particles through a liquid are different for different sizes. So procedure for this test is little bit difficult as compared to sieve analysis. Sieve analysis was done for coarse grain soil. In the last video, I have already explained the detailed procedure of sieve analysis. So I would suggest first watch the video of sieve analysis so that it will be easy to understand this video. I will share the link in the description of sieve analysis. So first of all, we will take 50 gram of the soil sample passing through 75 microns. Then the sample is put in an evaporating dish and is covered with 100 cc of distilled water. After that, about 100 cc of deflocculating agent, for example sodium oxalate, is added and the sample allowed to soak for 5 minutes. The sample is then transferred into dispersion cup. The cup is filled 3/4 using distilled water. After the suspension is started from 10 minutes, the suspension is transferred to 1000 cc jar. Then the suspension in the jar is mixed thoroughly. After that, the hydrometer is inserted in the suspension. A stopwatch is started immediately and the reading of hydrometer taken after 15 seconds, 30 seconds, 1 minute and 2 minutes. Then the hydrometer is taken out of the suspension. The soil suspension is again mixed thoroughly and the stopwatch is restarted. Reading for hydrometer are taken after 5, 10, 15, 30 minutes, 1, 2, 4 hours, etc. That is, the reading in hydrometer is taken as RH, that will be the observed hydrometer reading. A few corrections are also to be applied to the hydrometer reading. As the suspension is opaque, the hydrometer reading corresponds to the upper label of the meniscus. A correction due to meniscus is then applied to the hydrometer reading. The hydrometer are generally calibrated at 27 degrees Celsius. In case the temperature of the suspension is other than 27 degrees Celsius, a correction due to temperature, that is CT, is to be applied, is above the standard. If the test temperature is above the standard, the correction is added, means it will be plus CT, and if below it is subtracted, means it will be minus CT. So it will depend on the temperature. Temperature correction chart is usually supplied by the manufacturer. The correction due to rise in specific gravity of suspension on account of the addition of the deflocculating agent is called dispersing agent correction, that is CD. And remember, CD is always negative. Thus, the corrected hydrometer reading is RC is equal to RH plus correction due to meniscus plus minus CT, that is temperature correction, minus CD, dispersing agent correction. Since CD is always negative, so it is minus, but CT is maybe positive.